Nancy Camden. I just want to preface my questions by saying that I've lived rurally all of my 70 years, except 14 years. So I've lived among farmers and hunters and people with guns. And I think that even farmers and people and hunters with guns and collectors, I was married 20 years to a gun collector who did basically target practicing, and he was a member of the NRA. Until the NRA became something other than a sportsman's group, until it became a political powerhouse that overruled common sense gun control. I would like you, first of all, you have my email address, and I would both like to know how much money you've taken from the NRA over your political career. I'd like to know if you've signed any sorts of agreements, contracts, letters of support to the NRA. And I'd like to know, you know, what your position is with the NRA, because we feel, I think a lot of people feel, even Republicans and hunters and gun collectors feel that we've gone too far, and we need, this cannot be, this gun violence in our society cannot be addressed by just addressing mental health illness. And by the way, where has everybody been on that over the years? We've ignored that. It cannot, you know, we have privileges and licenses and insurance we have to get to drive a vehicle, which can be a weapon too. Why don't we have more restrictions on who can walk out of a gun show with an AR-15 at age 18 and do whatever they want that day with it? We need some things other than, I know the Republican Party wants to focus on mental health and issues that don't have to do with that AR-15, which was a weapon designed for the military. We are not trying to take away everyone's guns. No, that is put out there to make everyone afraid of dealing with this AR-15 in our society. And I want to know, I want to get an email about all the money.
So, can I just pause for right there? You're talking about campaign issues, and it is actually illegal for us to talk about campaign issues.
Well, tell me when I can.
It's not a campaign issue.
It's all available online on the FEC.
I can tell you, I'm not sure overall how much for the NRA. The NRA, as long as it was in the state legislature, to my knowledge, was not giving money to state legislators. I'm not sure what I've got since then, but I'm sure it's a tiny, tiny percentage of the amount of my campaign. I think people are legitimately concerned that people want to take all the guns because you look what happened in Great Britain, you look what happened in Australia. That's what happened there. I think as far as concern, for the crime rate in this country, like I said, I think between 1980 and until a couple of years ago, the murder rate was consistently falling in this country. And I think the murder rate was consistently falling, largely because of increased incarceration rates supported by many of the same politicians, largely the same politicians who pride themselves in their support of the Second Amendment. So, and I think that was a good story, the degree to which the murder rate fell. Again, I'll suggest you look at the murder rate in some of the other countries around the world, including south of our border, and areas in which they hold out stricter gun control laws than here, and they, in many cases, have much higher higher homicide rates.
Are you a member of the NRA?
I don't think so. I have been in the past, I'll tell you that. I don't know that my subscription or whatever ran out or not. Sure.
But the murder rate is not the same as the gun death rate. That's why
we're not going to talk over everyone else. Yeah. We're taking up.
Well, the point has to be made because nobody seems to know the truth.
We talked about this in the beginning. We're not going
to change
this.
Yeah,
gun deaths are going up.
Sir, we've talked about this in the beginning. You've been at many of our town halls. You know that you can't talk.
I'm not going to sit still for lies.
Yeah. No. Okay, Mary Williams, you're up.